and welcome to Sweden. My name is Kia, and today I will talk a little about Gotland wool. I have been preparing some Gotland wool here, and I wanted to share with you. The first thing that I did was to put it in really, really hot water to just get it cleaned a little bit. So I think I had it 3 or 4 waters with really hot water, and then I just had it in the sunshine to dry. So yesterday I spent the day outside, and I took all of this Gotland wool. And this is how it looks after it has been washed. It is just long locks like this, and they are a little bit stuck together, as you can see. And I just sat in the sun and I opened every lock up, just to, first of all, to get it really, really dry, because you know when the hair gets stuck together, the wet stays also. But I have been going through most of my fibers now, and one more thing that's really nice is that I get to take away all these shortcuts. So from all this wool that I have been sorting, this is the shortcuts that I have been taking out. So that's a really good thing to get away from the fiber. That's also what is peeling when you are wearing a sweater. That's the shortcuts that's creeping out from the garment. And this is, by the way, a sweater that I have been knitting from Gotland wool. So the first thing, from washed, it looks like this. And after opening it up, it becomes like this. So I have done nothing more than just opening up the locks, and it will turn out like this. And after that, I have a drum carder, a classic drum carder. And I just, I have filmed a little bit so you can see, but I want to show you also that this is the first, I'm taking it through the carder once, and then it looks like this. So I have quite a lovely fiber here to spin from. But I also did one more when I took it through the drum carder twice. So this is perfect. Now I can really, really spin some lovely yarn from this. So I wanted you to see all these stages from this just curly locks like this, and with a little human hands, it turns like this, and then you can spin lovely, lovely Gotland from it. But I have filmed a little bit while sitting in the sun opening up the fibers, also when I have been winding it through the drum carder now. And yes, we shall see if it will be if it will continue with some spinning and knitting later on. But right now, this is what I have for you.
So this is how it looks before I have done anything with it. I just washed it and then it looks like this. And here I have opened every little lock up. So it's a fluffy, nice little basket here. And these are the small, short fibers that I picked them out when I was looking through all these locks. I picked those shortcuts out. This is how it looks. The first round in the drum carder, and you can see there is still some beautiful locks here, and they haven't been worked enough in the carder. And this is how it looks after two rounds in the drum carder. Beautiful, beautiful fiber. This is one that I have rolled up to a bat, as you buy it in the store when you buy fibers. They look like this. So now they are all ready to spin. Beautiful Gotland wool.
So here I am with my basket filled with carded Gotland wool. And yes, I bought 500 grams of fibers from a farmer. And I don't get very much waste. This is the small shortcuts that I have sorted out. And this is what has stuck on the small drum, on the drum carder. So I didn't want to take that in because it's a lot of shorter fibers. And yes, they say that the waste will get stuck on the smaller drum. So I have chosen to take this aside. So I will not be use this. But 500 grams of beautiful, beautiful carded wool. And I'm really happy, I must say. So the fibers are now ready to be spun, and I think I will spin it on my Kromski minstrel, because I am working on another spin on my e-spinner, and it's a little bit too much, I think, to be spinning on the spindles. So I think I will use my Kromski minstrel for this spin. Yes, I hope that you enjoyed this little clip with me preparing the fibers and also seeing the finished beauty here, 500 grams. And I'm hoping to get enough to knit a sweater. And this is the Fore sweater by a yarn company here in Sweden called Yllotyll. And this is knitted in Gotland wool. But I will put the link to the pattern down below so you can have a look at it if you want to. Bye bye!